Hello everyone, good afternoon. Myself Surbhi Atara from SKM Science and Milani Arts Commerce College, Khatamji. So my topic of intercollegiate seminar competition is stereochemistry. First of all, I would like to show you all the contents of my presentation. So in today's presentation, I'll be talking about stereochemistry, isomerism, optical isomerism, asymmetric carbon atom, elements of symmetry, configuration. Further, I focus on D and L configuration, R and S configuration, cis trans nomenclature, and at last but not the least, EZ nomenclature. So, the first question arises in our mind is what is stereochemistry? It is the branch of chemistry which deals with the study of arrangement of atoms or groups or molecules in three-dimensional form. So, to understand further concepts, we need to understand the concept of isomerism. What are isomers? Iso means same or equal. The compounds having same molecular formula but different physical or chemical properties or both are called as isomers of each other, and this phenomenon is known as isomerism. Isomerism can further be categorized into structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism is also divided into chain isomerism, positional isomerism, functional isomerism, and metamerism. Whereas stereoisomerism is divided into geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. Next is the concept of structural isomerism. Structure, the word tells us about arrangement. So if two or more compounds differ in relative arrangement of atoms in the molecule, they are said to be the structural isomers of each other, and this phenomenon is known as structural isomerism. Based on this, there are four types of structural isomerism: functional isomerism, position isomerism, chain or nuclear isomerism, and metamerism. Next is stereoisomerism. Again, there is difference in relative arrangement of atoms or groups, but it is in three-dimensional form. According to this, there are three kinds of stereoisomerism. First is optical isomerism. Before talking about optical isomerism, I will speak about plane polarized light. The light whose vibration occurs only in one direction is called plane polarized light. So the isomers that rotate plane of plane polarized light are called as optical isomers, and the phenomenon of their existence is known as optical isomerism. Next is optical activity. The property of compounds to rotate plane polarized light in clockwise direction or in anticlockwise direction is called as optical activity. As you all can see in this diagram, plane of plane polarized light is vibrating in left direction as well as in the right direction. So, Professor William Nobles, Professor Roy D. Noyle, and Professor K. Barry Sharpless got Nobel Prize for synthesis of optically active compounds in the year 2001. Next are dextrorotatory and levorotatory compounds. The compounds which rotate the plane of plane polarized light in clockwise direction or to the right direction are called as dextrorotatory compounds and are denoted with small d or plus sign, whereas the compounds which rotate the plane polarized light in anticlockwise direction or in the left direction are called as levorotatory compounds, denoted with small l or minus sign. Next is very important concept of asymmetrical carbon atom. As we all know that carbon has four valencies, and if all the four valencies of carbon atom are filled with different groups, then that carbon atom is called as asymmetrical carbon atom. It is denoted by star trig and also called as chiral center. Next, I'll focus on elements of symmetry. There are three main types of elements of symmetry: plane of symmetry, center of symmetry, and axis of symmetry. If imaginary plane which divides a molecule into two equal parts, then the molecule possesses plane of symmetry. And if an imaginary line which passes through center of molecule which meets identical atom or molecule at same distance is said to be center of symmetry. Next is axis of symmetry. If an axis or line divides an object or molecule into two equal halves, then it is called as axis of symmetry. Axis of symmetry has two types: N-pole axis of symmetry and N-pole alternating axis of symmetry. Next is configuration. What is configuration? The particular arrangement of atoms and groups in space characterizing a particular stereoisomers is called configuration. Configuration has further two types: absolute configuration and relative configuration. The actual arrangement of atoms in space of optically active compound is called absolute configuration, whereas The configuration relationship between two optically active compounds can be determined by converting one into another by reaction. Now, D and L configuration. So, D and L system is used to specify configuration at asymmetric carbon atom. These are two examples, L-lactic acid and D-lactic acid. Next, I will talk about R and S configuration, that is sector and sinister configuration. If the rotation is in clockwise direction, means this diagram, then it is R configuration, and if it is in anticlockwise direction, then it is S configuration. The priority is given based on atomic number, that is the atom or group with highest atomic number will get the first priority. Next is geometrical isomerism. Geometry, the word itself tells us about the arrangement, and iso means same or equal. So, having same molecular formula but differing in arrangement of atoms or groups about the double bond in space are called as geometrical isomers, and this phenomenon is known as geometrical isomerism. Here are two examples, cis form of malic acid and trans form of fumaric acid. Next, I will talk about cis trans nomenclature. When the same group is present on same side of double bond, then it is cis isomer, whereas if same group are present on either sides of double bond, then it is trans isomer. Cis and trans nomenclature cannot be used to designate or specify a geometrical isomer. As I said that cis trans nomenclature is not used to designate or specify a geometrical isomer, we use EZ nomenclature. In this nomenclature, priority is given to the atom or group with highest atomic number. So, the higher priority atoms or groups, if present on the same side of the double bond, that is C double bond C, they are designated by letter Z, and if they are present on either side of the double bond, they are designated by letter E. So, these are the references of my presentation. I hope you all liked my presentation and got some information about stereochemistry. Thank you.